And we will talk about Kubernetes and Harbor and the Kubespray. How can we use this tools to deploy on the Kubernetes cluster and talk about how to set up Kubespray in an air gap or offline environment? So what is an air gap offline environment?
So,
in offline
environment,
so for the air gap network, it's like a private network, and we can call it an offline environment. 像一些政府企业或者是一些大公司，他们可能会用，或者是一些私有的China or private cloud users，他们有哪些困难？比如说他们要保护，they want to protect the users' privacy，or they already maintaining own infrastructure and CDN，and also they have some cost considerations. So how the
Kubernetes
supported air gap and offline installers. There's something we need to pay attention to. For example, the Kubernetes images list.
就是我们可以通过，你们允许去配置我们的这样服务器。
We can use the image repository to configure the
Kubernetes.
And also another point is about the version of the Kubernetes. For some large corporations, they might customize their own KAS version, which might differ from the community version. In this case, the Kubernetes would not support.
如果你跟社区Kubernetes的话，你说你好像这个开发组件的部署吧，应该有两个方法，一种就是Kubernetes这种方式，so
we can use the Kubernetes config map, and the version must be like v1.11.10 or v1.12.1. So the Kubernetes check will not have like errors. When we run the Kubernetes, it has some performance check or performance test, like Kotlin check or RPVS check. And also, we have this method for the Kubernetes version deployment. And another thing is the deployment of etcd version. Because it will affect the upstream of the Kubernetes. Because large corporations, they need to publish their own versions in order to solve their own problems. So, this is based on the feedback from the Kubecon 2018 and supported a version 1.13. So we can use the Kubernetes to specify the version. In version 1.12, Kubernetes has solved the offline and air gap support issues like version check. So this is for the version check issue, and another is for the fix offline and air gap support. It's about the optimization of the usage. Sometimes we have some like interruptions of the operation or interruption of the Kubernetes run. So the Kubernetes can help to fix this problem. So with the support, it can help you to overcome this interruption, and also it will give you some warnings. For Kubernetes deployments in the air gap and the offline. So here on this slide, we can have this Kubernetes installed. So in the private environment, only one or two machines can access to the network. The other machines are in the isolated environment. And then we can copy the data we need to the master or node. For the first master, we can have a Kubernetes controlling node, and we will have a Kubernetes join control plane, and when we have the Kubernetes join control plane, we can deploy the calculation node. So if we want to scale up or scale down, we can use the Kubernetes join control plane to achieve the scaling.
So actually, if you look at this process, there's a lot of other configurations, like a Kubernetes, interconfigure, and a cast configure, and a Kubernetes configure. And they will generate four configure maps documents, and especially class configure, it is quite troublesome. If you want to deploy, optimize the cluster, then class configure will have like network or etcd or API server schedule, control manager, some parameters configuration. If you add all them up, you have to maintain. I tried, it is 300 lines of configuration. So it's quite difficult to maintain, especially you have to look very hard to find a certain change of parameters. So do we have optimized method? There's actually like class API, Kubespray. So, and also the mirror management, such as image registry, we can use Harbor to store, and use Kubespray to manage our Kuba cluster. So Harbor, it's a cloud native image registry, and for Kubespray, it is it makes cluster management easier. It supports KubeDM. Actually, from V Alpha 1 to Alpha 2, Alpha 3 to Beta 1 version, Kubespray supports all of them. So you can switch the clusters you want to configure, which is very easy.
Harbor.
It's a trusted cloud native registry that stores signs and scans content. The mission is to provide cloud native environments the ability to confidently manage and serve container images. So Harbor Architect, actually, we just care how it is used, like use home charge or dot com use to install Harbor, and how to push the mirrors into the Harbor, or how to, through your CI/CD pipeline, to push your mirrors into the Harbor. We only care for this process. Typical use cases, for example, image consistency through software lifecycle. And shipping images in binary format, image replication unlocks interesting deployment architects, authentication, and vulnerability scanning. For example, this way, to shipping binaries in production environment, maybe we want to clone Kubernetes in-house. So we can use Kubernetes, then push it to dev registry, and then push it to hub mirror, and then put it in test registry, and finally into staging registry, then finally into production. And Kubespray is a cluster lifecycles project to create, configure, and manage Kubernetes clusters. It provides optional additive functionality on top of core Kubernetes. And Kubespray is a cluster lifecycle manager. It's flexible and composable, and it is production ready, and is Ansible-based, one-package-based component, multi-arc, community-driven since 2015, and the base of KubeDM since 2018, and certified Kubernetes installer. So the deployment workflow, you check what system I use, and then do pre-install step, like check the firewalls, etc., and check Docker's, check to do some pre-install steps, and then install Docker, install etcd, install master, install minion, and configure network plugin. And based on your own need, you can put on some add-ons like a dashboard or storage plugins. And high availability. So etcd, it provides native support for all clients to connect to all etcd instances. API server, it is for, you can use local LB as well as external LB, including cloud LB or F5. And Kubespray also provide local LB like Nginx proxy, which is a stack deployed in Kubernetes cluster. Local LB's architect. You can see the traffic goes through Nginx or HA proxy and convert it to and become highly available. So for this architect, it's more economical, cost efficient. If you use F5 or Cloud LB, they are all charge based. It provides also you a lot of user options, including OS, network, and the Kubernetes features, container engine, and the deployment mode. So this is offline options. Next, Kubernetes offline options. For its binaries, if its binary is exchanged into your own URL or your on-premise URL. And also images, you can use in Docker. It supports HTTPS. And the system packages, it supports your own resource for Docker installment. And Helm charts. So this link give you the specific configures for offline options. And for error gap options, for example, Kubespray pull once, push many. If this environment is only accessed by one machine, then we could configure download localhost. So the tool to make localhost download delegate. This can be useful if cluster nodes cannot access external addresses. You can also download the container images and the binaries only once and then push them to the cluster nodes. But this comes with two conditions. One is you have to pre-configure Docker, and you should also boost the dock in advance. And also have cache functions. It can the images are stored at your local storage. So if you call master, it will copy from the local host. It also guarantee the cache. It can also be stored in cache in cloud. If you can use the images in cloud or binaries to upgrade. So it's some of its specific configurations you can try. We also add API to test because you know there's a OVH company in France, a OpenStack based company, and provide us this environment. So one member of our community also did a test on that. You can check it out. Air gap. You should have it. So that's for the Kubernetes LGAP and offline configuration. There's also some Proxmoor, like Kubernetes does not support, only supports part of the software package install. If you're interested, you can check online. And the community grew very fast. We have 6,400 stars, 2,600 forks, over 4,400 commits, and 450 contributors. So you can contact us with these contacts. Like Kubespray China. So if you're interested, you can add this WeChat. Next, I will talk about how to set up a Kubespray in an air gap offline environment in combination of Harbor to manage your Kubernetes cluster. Of course, you have to be ready because Harbor supports offline install, so you can install offline. You can collect images and publish images or through CI pipeline to push images to the field. And the Kubespray, you only three steps: install requirements.txt and modify the rows, download images, the registry. So basically your hub address, and then install Kubernetes clusters and add private register options. And I said that you also can provide some offline options. It depends on what model you choose, which model you choose. Life cycle of cluster operations, here it is. You have these, for example, cluster YAM, install or reconfigure a cluster. Reconfigure like into a cluster, a scale master, a scale node. And also update a new, and also you can gracefully rolling upgrade to a new version with upgrade cluster.yml, and also scale is to add a node to an existing cluster, and the remove node is to remove a particular node from a cluster, and the reset is uninstall an entire cluster.
We can see some install capacity parameters. We can specify a KPass version, and then we can add on registries non-secure URL. And then you can use the Ansible to install it. For scale node, it's simple. And show on the slide is telling you how to configure it. For scale master, it has two scenarios. You can use local LB. For local LB, you need to use ADM to generate the certificate for each node, and also need to update the NGS process configuration for each calculation node. and to direct the traffic to the new generated master node. But for the external, LB is much simpler. And for different versions, so when you use different versions, you need to pay attention to whether it can generate this ticket or the.
This is Scale Master,
And for upgrade cluster.
Upgrade cluster.
For example, you want to upgrade to V1.13, you just need to upgrade the version. And also support other applications like Docker, etcd, master, kubelet, network. So you can have a stepped upgrade to decrease the possibility of the failure for the whole cluster upgrade. By stepped upgrade, it's much safer.
Remove
node and uninstall cluster. Remove node is very simple. Uninstall is also very simple. Use reset the YAML to delete the whole cluster. Thank you very much. Any questions? So we need to give the certificate to the LB. And in Kubernetes, it should provide like a VIP URL. So it's like mutual dependence.
We use TCP to solve this.
But we cannot achieve the load balancing. You use what VIP do you use?
We use PIPLAB, like LB
VIP. So you already created the certificate on the node. For example, you have three master. For each node, you run a Kubernetes, and VIP is on one of the three nodes. So you have the VIP ready. You can route to the three masters because it's Kubernetes EM. You can write the VIP to the control plane. Parameter of the Kube ADM, and you can achieve the system load balance. Kubespray should also support this. You just use called LB, you just need to configure it the LB IP address and the port. You can just go ahead and take a shot.
你好，我想咨询一下，就是我们刚才升级来说，就是通过那个
upgrade
一个 update 然后 custom 那个脚本，我们用那个样文件来做。那如果是升级是想回退的话，是通过那个是吧？We
also use the same script. What do you mean by rollback? For example, they upgrade, we find some problem with the version, we want to roll back to the old version. You can use the cluster DIM. Kubernetes supported the rollback. So when we have an automatic backup to the etcd, so when you roll back, you also have the automatic rollback of the backup snapshot. Well, you can have a try. I'm not very sure, but I know Kubespray support download. If Kubernetes supports this, then Kubespray will also support as well. Okay.
You
mentioned the offline download local host. There are some questions. Can you repeat it? I didn't quite understand. You need to pay attention to two problems. You need to run Docker and the deployment decision making. You have to install the Docker, start Docker, and then you can start the upgrade. If you want to download localhost, how can we install the Docker on the undeployed machine? You can have a pre-deployment, for example, you can write a ASPO sample to install the Docker in the offline environment, or you can use Tux to try. I use Kubespray to download local host to deploy. I found that in the target machine, we can use Kubespray to install the Docker button. Why we need the Docker runtime in the undeployed target machine? Because you need to sync the image to each node. And also, you need to execute the dock node. So, in theory, even though the target machine is offline, we can use the delegate the machine to install the Docker for the undeployed machine. Well, I don't think it's supported now. You can use VM or bare metal or KS file to install Docker by default, or you can create a VM model to calling the Docker by default. So you can try this too. So after we deploy the Kubespray, how can we test the function of the deployed cluster? Is any best practice? Kubespray, I think it has some test case. It can create a pod, or you can use a work check. There's a component to check the network, to pin the IP of the pods, and so if the pin is successful. And also the Kubespray can create some check for the function. And the third question, so how many people are doing the SIG for the project? Well, I don't have the specific number, but there are a lot of people. For example, an engineer from Ant Financial. They are also the contributor for the Kubespray SIG. So what do you do for this project? I used to be responsible for the Kubernetes. And I provide like the support for Alpha E, Alpha 1, Alpha 2, and Alpha 3. We can have more offline discussions. We don't have time anymore. We support different versions and also CR tasks. Thank you.